shloka. The True One is on his mind and the True One is upon his lips. He sees only the One. O Nanak, these are the qualities of the God-conscious being. Ashtapadi. The God-conscious being is always unattached as the lotus in the water remains detached. The God-conscious being is always unstained like the sun, which gives its comfort and warmth to all. The God-conscious being looks upon all alike like the wind, which blows equally upon the king and the poor beggar. The God-conscious being has a steady patience like the earth, which is dug up by one and anointed with sandal paste by another. This is the quality of the God-conscious being. O Nanak, his inherent nature is like a warming fire. The God-conscious being is the purest of the pure. Filth does not stick to water. The God-conscious being's mind is enlightened like the sky above the earth. To the God-conscious being, friend and foe are the same. The God-conscious being has no egotistical pride. The God-conscious being is the highest of the high. Within his own mind, he is the most humble of all. They alone become God-conscious beings, O Nanak, whom God himself makes so. The God-conscious being is the dust of all. The God-conscious being knows the nature of the soul. The God-conscious being shows kindness to all. No evil comes from the God-conscious being. The God-conscious being is always impartial. Nectar rains down from the glance of the God-conscious being. The God-conscious being is free from entanglements. The lifestyle of the God-conscious being is spotlessly pure. Spiritual wisdom is the food of the God-conscious being. O Nanak, the God-conscious being is absorbed in God's meditation. The God-conscious being centers his hopes on the One alone. The God-conscious being shall never perish. The God-conscious being is steeped in humility. The God-conscious being delights in doing good to others. The God-conscious being has no worldly entanglements. The God-conscious being holds his wandering mind under control. The God-conscious being acts in the common good. The God-conscious being blossoms in fruitfulness. In the company of the God-conscious being, all are saved. O Nanak, through the God-conscious being, the whole world meditates on God. The God-conscious being loves the One Lord alone. The God-conscious being dwells with God. The God-conscious being takes the Nam as his support. The God-conscious being has the Nam as his family. The God-conscious being is awake and aware forever and ever. The God-conscious being renounces his proud ego. In the mind of the God-conscious being, there is supreme bliss. In the home of the God-conscious being, there is everlasting bliss. The God-conscious being dwells in peaceful ease. O Nanak, the God-conscious being shall never perish. The God-conscious being knows God. The God-conscious being is in love with the One alone. The God-conscious being is carefree. Pure are the teachings of the God-conscious being. The God-conscious being is made so by himself. The God-conscious being is gloriously great. The darshan, the blessed vision of the God-conscious being, is obtained by great good fortune. To the God-conscious being, I make my life a sacrifice. The God-conscious being is sought by the great God Shiva. O Nanak, the God-conscious being is himself the Supreme Lord God. The God-conscious being cannot be appraised. The God-conscious being has all within his mind. Who can know the mystery of the God-conscious being? Forever bow to the God-conscious being. The God-conscious being cannot be described in words. The God-conscious being is the Lord and Master of all. Who can describe the limits of the God-conscious being? Only the God-conscious being can know the state of the God-conscious being. The God-conscious being has no end or limitation. O Nanak, to the God-conscious being, bow forever in reverence. The God-conscious being is the creator of all the world. The God-conscious being lives forever and does not die. The God-conscious being is the giver of the way of liberation of the soul. The God-conscious being is the perfect supreme being who orchestrates all. The God-conscious being is the helper of the helpless. The God-conscious being extends his hand to all. The God-conscious being owns the entire creation. The God-conscious being is himself the formless Lord. The glory of the God-conscious being belongs to the God-conscious being alone. O Nanak, the God-conscious being is the Lord of all. Shlok. One who enshrines the Nam within the heart, who sees the Lord God in all, who each and every moment bows in reverence to the Lord Master, O Nanak, such a one is the true touch-nothing saint who emancipates everyone. Ashtapadi. One whose tongue does not touch falsehood, whose mind is filled with love for the blessed vision of the pure Lord, whose eyes do not gaze upon the beauty of others' wives, who serves the holy and loves the saints' congregation, whose ears do not listen to slander against anyone, who deems himself to be the worst of all, who by Guru's grace renounces corruption, who banishes the mind's evil desires from his mind, who conquers his sexual instincts and is free of the five sinful passions. O Nanak, among millions, there is scarcely one such touch-nothing saint. The true Vaishnav, the devotee of Vishnu, is the one with whom God is thoroughly pleased. He dwells apart from Maya, performing good deeds, he does not seek rewards. Spotlessly pure is the religion of such a Vaishnav. He has no desire for the fruits of his labors. He is absorbed in devotional worship and the singing of kirtan, the songs of the Lord's glory. Within his mind and body, he meditates in remembrance on the Lord of the universe. He is kind to all creatures. He holds fast to the Nam and inspires others to chant it. O Nanak, such a Vaishnav obtains the supreme status. The true Bhagoti, the devotee of Adi Shakti, loves the devotional worship of God. He forsakes the company of all wicked people. All doubts are removed from his mind. He performs devotional service to the Supreme Lord God in all. In the company of the holy, the filth of sin is washed away. The wisdom of such a Bhagoti becomes supreme. He constantly performs the service of the Supreme Lord God. He dedicates his mind and body to the love of God. The lotus feet of the Lord abide in his heart. O Nanak, such a Bhagoti attains the Lord God. He is a true pundit, a religious scholar who instructs his own mind. He searches for the Lord's name within his own soul. He drinks in the exquisite nectar of the Lord's name. By that pundit's teachings, the world lives. He implants the sermon of the Lord in his heart. Such a pundit is not cast into the womb of reincarnation again. He understands the fundamental essence of the Vedas, the Puranas, and the Smritis. In the unmanifest, he sees the manifest world to exist. He gives instruction to people of all castes and social classes. O Nanak, to such a pundit, I bow in salutation forever. The Bij Mantra, the Seed Mantra, is spiritual wisdom for everyone. Anyone from any class may chant the Nam. Whoever chants it is emancipated. And yet, rare are those who attain it in the company of the holy. By his grace, he enshrines it within. Even beasts, ghosts, and the stone-hearted are saved. The Nam is the panacea, the remedy to cure all ills. Singing the glory of God is the embodiment of bliss and emancipation. It cannot be obtained by any religious rituals. O Nanak, he alone obtains it whose karma is so preordained. One whose mind is a home for the Supreme Lord God His name is truly Ram Dass, the Lord's servant. He comes to have the vision of the Lord, the Supreme Soul. Deeming himself to be the slave of the Lord's slaves, he obtains it. He knows the Lord to be ever-present, close at hand. Such a servant is honored in the court of the Lord. To his servant, he himself shows his mercy. Such a servant understands everything. Amidst all, his soul is unattached. Such is the way, O Nanak, of the Lord's servant. One who, in his soul, loves the will of God is said to be Jivan Mukta, liberated while yet alive. As is joy, so is sorrow to him. He is in eternal bliss and is not separated from God. As is gold, so is dust to him. As is ambrosial nectar, so is bitter poison to him. As is honor, so is dishonor. As is the beggar, so is the king. Whatever God ordains, that is his way. O Nanak, that being is known as Jivan Mukta. All places belong to the Supreme Lord God. According to the homes in which they are placed, so are his creatures named. He himself is the doer, the cause of causes. Whatever pleases God ultimately comes to pass. He himself is all-pervading in endless waves. The playful sport of the Supreme Lord God cannot be known. As the understanding is given, so is one enlightened. The Supreme Lord God, the Creator, is eternal and everlasting. Forever, forever and ever, he is merciful. Remembering him in meditation, O Nanak, one is blessed with ecstasy. Shlok. Many people praise the Lord. He has no end or limitation. O Nanak, God created the creation with its many ways and various species. Ashtapadi. Many millions are his devotees. Many millions perform religious rituals and worldly duties. Many millions become dwellers at sacred shrines of pilgrimage. Many millions wander as renunciates in the wilderness. Many millions listen to the Vedas. Many millions become austere penitents. Many millions enshrine meditation within their souls. Many millions of poets contemplate him through poetry. Many millions meditate on his eternally new Nam. O Nanak, none can find the limits of the Creator. Many millions become self-centered. Many millions are blinded by ignorance. Many millions are stone-hearted misers. Many millions are heartless with dry, withered souls. Many millions steal the wealth of others. Many millions slander others. Many millions struggle in Maya. Many millions wander in foreign lands. Whatever God attaches them to, with that they are engaged. O Nanak, the Creator alone knows the workings of his creation. Many millions are siddhas, celibates, and yogis. Many millions are kings enjoying worldly pleasures. Many millions of birds and snakes have been created. Many millions of stones and trees have been produced. Many millions are the winds, waters, and fires. Many millions are the countries and realms of the world. Many millions are the moons, suns, and stars. Many millions are the demigods, demons, and Indras under their regal canopies. He has strung the entire creation upon his thread. O Nanak, he emancipates those with whom he is pleased. Many millions abide in heated activity, slothful darkness, and peaceful light. Many millions are the Vedas, Puranas, Smritis, and Shastras. Many millions are the pearls of the ocean. Many millions are the beings of so many descriptions. Many millions are made long-lived. Many millions of hills and mountains have been made of gold. Many millions are the Yakshas, the servants of the God of wealth, the Kinnars, the gods of celestial music, and the evil spirits of the Pasak. Many millions are the evil nature spirits, ghosts, pigs, and tigers. He is near to all and yet far from all. O Nanak, he himself remains distinct while yet pervading all. Many millions inhabit the nether regions. Many millions dwell in heaven and hell. Many millions are born, live, and die. Many millions are reincarnated over and over again. Many millions eat while sitting at ease. Many millions are exhausted by their labors. Many millions are created wealthy. Many millions are anxiously involved in Maya. Wherever he wills, there he keeps us. O Nanak, everything is in the hands of God. Many millions become Bairagis, who renounce the world. They have attached themselves to the Lord's name. Many millions are searching for the God. Within their souls, they find the Supreme Lord God. Many millions thirst for the blessing of God's darshan. They meet with God, the Eternal. Many millions pray for the society of the saints. They are imbued with the love of the Supreme Lord God. Those with whom he himself is pleased, O Nanak, are blessed, forever blessed. Many millions are the fields of creation and the galaxies. Many millions are the etheric skies and the solar systems. Many millions are the divine incarnations. In so many ways, he has unfolded himself. So many times, he has expanded his expansion. Forever and ever, he is the one universal creator. Many millions are created in various forms. From God, they emanate, and into God, they merge once again. His limits are not known to anyone. Of himself and by himself, O Nanak, God exists. Many millions are the servants of the Supreme Lord God. Their souls are enlightened. Many millions know the essence of reality. Their eyes gaze forever on the One alone. Many millions drink in the essence of the Nam. They become immortal. They live forever and ever. Many millions sing the glorious praises of the Nam. They are absorbed in intuitive peace and pleasure. He remembers his servants with each and every breath. O Nanak, they are the beloveds of the transcendent Lord God. Shlok. God alone is the doer of deeds. There is no other at all. O Nanak, I am a sacrifice to the one who pervades the waters, the lands, the sky, and all space. Ashtapadi. The doer, the cause of causes, is potent to do anything. That which pleases him comes to pass. In an instant he creates and destroys. He has no end or limitation. By his order he established the earth and he maintains it unsupported. By his order the world was created. By his order it shall merge again into him. By his order one's occupation is high or low. By his order there are so many colors and forms. Having created the creation, he beholds his own greatness. O Nanak, he is pervading in all. If it pleases God, one attains salvation. If it pleases God, then even stones can swim. If it pleases God, the body is preserved even without the breath of life. If it pleases God, then one chants the Lord's glorious praises. If it pleases God, then even sinners are saved. He himself acts and he himself contemplates. He himself is the master of both worlds. He plays and he enjoys. He is the inner knower, the searcher of hearts. As he wills, he causes actions to be done. Nanak sees no other than him. Tell me, what can a mere mortal do? Whatever pleases God is what he causes us to do. If it were in our hands, we would grab up everything. Whatever pleases God, that is what he does. Through ignorance, people are engrossed in corruption. If they knew better, they would save themselves. Deluded by doubt, they wander around in the 10 directions. In an instant, their minds go around the four corners of the world and come back again. Those whom the Lord mercifully blesses with his devotional worship, O Nanak, they are absorbed into the Nam. In an instant, the lowly worm is transformed into a king. The Supreme Lord God is the protector of the humble. Even one who has never been seen at all becomes instantly famous in the 10 directions. And that one upon whom he bestows his blessings, the Lord of the world does not hold him to his account. Soul and body are all his property. Each and every heart is illumined by the perfect Lord God. He himself fashioned his own handiwork. Nanak lives by beholding his greatness. There is no power in the hands of mortal beings. The doer, the cause of causes, is the Lord of all. The helpless beings are subject to his command. That which pleases him ultimately comes to pass. Sometimes they abide in exaltation. Sometimes they are depressed. Sometimes they are sad, and sometimes they laugh with joy and delight. Sometimes they are occupied with slander and anxiety. Sometimes they are high in the Akashic ethers. Sometimes in the nether regions of the underworld. Sometimes they know the contemplation of God. O Nanak, God himself unites them with himself. Sometimes they dance in various ways. Sometimes they remain asleep day and night. Sometimes they are awesome in terrible rage. Sometimes they are the dust of the feet of all. Sometimes they sit as great kings. Sometimes they wear the coat of a lowly beggar. Sometimes they come to have evil reputations. Sometimes they are known as very, very good. As God keeps them, so they remain. By Guru's grace, O Nanak, the truth is told. Sometimes as scholars they deliver lectures. Sometimes they hold to silence in deep meditation. Sometimes they take cleansing baths at places of pilgrimage. Sometimes as siddhas or seekers, they impart spiritual wisdom. Sometimes they become worms, elephants, or moths. They may wander and roam through countless incarnations. In various costumes like actors, they appear. As it pleases God, they dance. Whatever pleases him comes to pass. O Nanak, there is no other at all. Sometimes this being attains the company of the holy. From that place, he does not have to come back again. The light of spiritual wisdom dawns within. That place does not perish. The mind and body are imbued with the love of the Nam, the name of the one Lord. He dwells forever with the Supreme Lord God. As water comes to blend with water, his light blends into the light. Reincarnation is ended and eternal peace is found. Nanak is forever a sacrifice to God. Shlok. The humble beings abide in peace. Subduing egotism, they are meek. The very proud and arrogant persons, O Nanak, are consumed by their own pride. Ashtapadi. One who has the pride of power within shall dwell in hell and become a dog. One who deems himself to have the beauty of youth shall become a maggot in manure. One who claims to act virtuously shall live and die, wandering through countless reincarnations. One who takes pride in wealth and lands is a fool, blind, and ignorant. One whose heart is mercifully blessed with abiding humility, O Nanak, is liberated here and obtains peace hereafter. One who becomes wealthy and takes pride in it, not even a piece of straw shall go along with him. He may place his hopes on a large army of men, but he shall vanish in an instant. One who deems himself to be the strongest of all, in an instant shall be reduced to ashes. One who thinks of no one else except his own prideful self, the righteous judge of Dharma, shall expose his disgrace. One who, by Guru's grace, eliminates his ego, O Nanak, becomes acceptable in the court of the Lord. If someone does millions of good deeds while acting in ego, he shall incur only trouble. All this is in vain. If someone performs great penance while acting in selfishness and conceit, he shall be reincarnated into heaven and hell over and over again. He makes all sorts of efforts but his soul is still not softened. How can he go to the court of the Lord, one who calls himself good? Goodness shall not draw near him. One whose mind is the dust of all, says Nanak, his reputation is spotlessly pure. As long as someone thinks that he is the one who acts, he shall have no peace. As long as this mortal thinks that he is the one who does things, he shall wander in reincarnation through the womb. As long as he considers one an enemy and another a friend, his mind shall not come to rest. As long as he is intoxicated with attachment to Maya, the righteous judge shall punish him. By God's grace, his bonds are shattered. By Guru's grace, O Nanak, his ego is eliminated. Earning 1,000, he runs after 100,000. Satisfaction is not obtained by chasing after Maya. He may enjoy all sorts of corrupt pleasures, but he is still not satisfied. He indulges again and again, wearing himself out until he dies. Without contentment, no one is satisfied. Like the objects in a dream, all his efforts are in vain. Through the love of the Nam, all peace is obtained. Only a few obtain this by great good fortune. He himself is himself the cause of causes. Forever and ever, O Nanak, chant the Lord's name. The doer, the cause of causes, is the Creator Lord. What deliberations are in the hands of mortal beings? As God casts his glance of grace, they come to be. God himself, of himself, is unto himself. Whatever he created was by his own pleasure. He is far from all, and yet with all. He understands, he sees, and he passes judgment. He himself is the one, and he himself is the many. He does not die or perish. He does not come and go. O Nanak, he remains forever all-pervading. He himself instructs and he himself learns. He himself mingles with all. He himself created his own expanse. All things are his. He is the creator. Without him, what could be done? In the spaces and interspaces, he is the one. In his own play, he himself is the actor. He produces his plays with infinite variety. He himself is in the mind, and the mind is in him. O Nanak, his worth cannot be estimated. True, true, true is God, our Lord and Master. By Guru's grace, some speak of him. True, true, true is the Creator of all. Out of millions, scarcely anyone knows him. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful is your sublime form. You are exquisitely beautiful, infinite and incomparable. Pure, pure, pure is the world of your bani, heard in each and every heart, spoken to the ears. Holy, 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 and sublimely pure. Chant the Nam, O Nanak, with heartfelt love. Shlok. One who seeks the sanctuary of the saints shall be saved. One who slanders the saints, O Nanak, shall be reincarnated over and over again. Ashtapadi. Slandering the saints, one's life is cut short. Slandering the saints, one shall not escape the messenger of death. Slandering the saints, all happiness vanishes. Slandering the saints, one falls into hell. Slandering the saints, the intellect is polluted. Slandering the saints, one's reputation is lost. One who is cursed by a saint cannot be saved. Slandering the saints, one's place is defiled. But if the compassionate saint shows his kindness, O Nanak, in the company of the saints, the slanderer may still be saved. Slandering the saints, one becomes a wry-faced malcontent. Slandering the saints, one croaks like a raven. Slandering the saints, one is reincarnated as a snake. Slandering the saints, one is reincarnated as a wiggling worm. Slandering the saints, one burns in the fire of desire. Slandering the saints, one tries to deceive everyone. Slandering the saints, all one's influence vanishes. slandering the saints, one becomes the lowest of the low. For the slanderer of the saint, there is no place of rest. O Nanak, if it pleases the saint, even then he may be saved. The slanderer of the saint is the worst evildoer. The slanderer of the saint has not even a moment's rest. The slanderer of the saint is a brutal butcher. The slanderer of the saint is cursed by the transcendent Lord. The slanderer of the saint has no kingdom. The slanderer of the saint becomes miserable and poor. The slanderer of the saint contracts all diseases. The slanderer of the saint is forever separated. To slander a saint is the worst sin of sins. O Nanak, if it pleases the saint, then even this one may be liberated. The slanderer of the saint is forever impure. The slanderer of the saint is nobody's friend. The slanderer of the saint shall be punished. The slanderer of the saint is abandoned by all. The slanderer of the saint is totally egocentric. The slanderer of the saint is forever corrupt. The slanderer of the saint must endure birth and death. The slanderer of the saint is devoid of peace. The slanderer of the saint has no place of rest. O Nanak, if it pleases the saint, then even such a one may merge in union. The slanderer of the saint breaks down midway. The slanderer of the saint cannot accomplish his tasks. The slanderer of the saint wanders in the wilderness. The slanderer of the saint is misled into desolation. The slanderer of the saint is empty inside, like the corpse of a dead man without the breath of life. The slanderer of the saint has no heritage at all. He himself must eat what he has planted. The slanderer of the saint cannot be saved by anyone else. O Nanak, if it pleases the saint, then even he may be saved. The slanderer of the saint bewails like this, like a fish out of water writhing in agony. The slanderer of the saint is hungry and is never satisfied, as fire is not satisfied by fuel. The slanderer of the saint is left all alone, like the miserable barren sesame stalk abandoned in the field. The slanderer of the saint is devoid of faith. The slanderer of the saint constantly lies. The fate of the slanderer is preordained from the very beginning of time. O Nanak, whatever pleases God's will comes to pass. The slanderer of the saint becomes deformed. The slanderer of the saint receives his punishment in the court of the Lord. The slanderer of the saint is eternally in limbo. He does not die, but he does not live either. The hopes of the slanderer of the saint are not fulfilled. The slanderer of the saint departs disappointed. Slandering the saint, no one attains satisfaction. As it pleases the Lord, so do people become. No one can erase their past actions. O Nanak, the true Lord alone knows all. All hearts are His. He is the Creator. Forever and ever I bow to Him in reverence. Praise God day and night. Meditate on Him with every breath and morsel of food. Everything happens as He wills. As He wills, so people become. He Himself is the play, and He Himself is the actor. Who can speak or deliberate upon this? He Himself gives His name to those upon whom He bestows His mercy. Very fortunate, O Nanak, are those people.